Hey folks, welcome back. Today I am at the Local in downtown Warner, and with me is the proprietor of the Local, Bill Meadows. Bill, what's shaking?
Not much.
So things cranking down here?
Yeah, things are going good. Can't complain.
Anything new we should know about? Creations?
We're working on some stuff. Tiffany, my wife, is back in the kitchen full time, so that allows us to be a lot more creative in the kitchen, do some better daily specials than we were able to do.
Now, you're not being sexist with the wife in the kitchen thing.
No, not at all.
She's a good cook.
Absolutely. She's right. The whole reason this works, because the quality of the food is all because of her. So I get the credit because I'm out front all the time, but I have very little to do with the food.
You can barely boil water.
Pretty much, yeah. They don't let me back in the kitchen too often.
I don't blame them. So you still got a good selection of the imported beers too.
Yeah, we're rolling on the craft beers. We're trying to move more towards New England craft beers, New Hampshire specifically. You know, it's a little bit difficult just because it's craft beer doesn't mean it's good. So
right.
We're trying, you know, we try. Right now we're up around 70 total beers.
Wow.
I would say 90% of which are craft. We carry, you know, a few major domestics, you know, because we got to have something for everybody.
Right.
Tagline. But yeah, it's like I said, it's 90% craft, and I'd say close to 30-40% New England.
Wow, that's pretty good.
Yeah, that's what we're working towards. And, you know, one point we rotate the tap handles a lot. At one point we had 4 New Hampshire beers on.
Really?
So yeah, it's hard to do all the time because some of these local breweries are small and supply is an issue. But we do as much as possible. In fact, right now, 4 New England beers, 2 New Hampshire, 1 Maine, and 1 Connecticut.
So, Connecticut.
Yep.
Ooh, which one's the Connecticut?
Two Roads. They just made the break into New Hampshire, so they're heavily marketing. I do really good work. I've been following them for a while, and it's nice that they're in New Hampshire now.
I'll have to try one later.
Yep.
I do like the Great North.
The Great North out of Manchester is doing great work. We're selling a ton of it. We can't keep it in stock. Swift Current as well, who's also out of Manchester. We got their Irish Red now. They're a fun one because they do a batch, sell it, then do another batch, so we get something different every time.
Keep it interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're running the Irish Red now with St. Patrick's Day coming up. So.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Yep.
And you have the music.
Music, yeah. Every we're back to Fridays and Saturdays here pretty quick. So doing an open mic actually this weekend, but for the most part it's acoustic on Friday and, you know, bands on Saturday. We don't charge a cover. We're here for the music.
You get some really good acts.
We had some really quality acts, you know, mostly out of Concord. We're branching out a little bit, Manchester. We got one group out of Nashua that comes up that does really well. Songs with Molly, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
A bunch of young kids who do mostly 70s, 80s, and 90s. I don't think they play a song that was written after they were born. So, but it's a good time. They do a good job.
Excellent. You still doing trivia night?
Still doing trivia every Thursday. It's one of our most consistent nights. We get a nice mix of regulars and newbies in there. It's always spirited but fun, you know.
Oh yeah, that can be interesting. Yeah, I've been around for a couple of those. Yeah, they get interesting.
Yeah, it never gets, you know, it gets spirited is a good word to use for it, but nobody takes it too seriously.
And still got Taco Tuesdays.
Taco Tuesdays every Tuesday. Doing wings on Wednesday now.
That's wings.
You know, we're a destination location, so, you know, we like to have something going, something special every night of the week. The wings have gone really well. You know, it's a pound of wings, you know, priced well, choice of sauce, you know. Don't charge extra for the blue cheese and the ranch and the vegetables.
Don't nickel and dime me to death.
Don't nickel and dime me to death, so.
And with, you know, nicer weather coming, the farmers, you try and do a lot with local produce, a lot of local farmers.
We do,
too,
we do. Once the local farms get out and start producing again, we really try to do our daily specials with the local farm produce, with whether it's Kearsarge Gore Farm, Green Hill Collective, Michelle's Garden, you know, or some others. We work really nicely with the spring and summer vegetables, meat on occasion. You know, it just depends on what's available, and that's kind of the fun thing. Hey, what do you got today? And then we try to, you know, create a special around it.
Keep it local.
Absolutely, as much as possible.
So, folks, you keep it local, too. Come on down to the Local in Warner and say hi to Bill.